Welcome to another video about TMS Web Core. Today I would like to introduce you to the Lazarus support that's now finally included in the new release of TMS Web Core. It was already possible to include TMS Web Core in Lazarus with previous releases, however, now we fully support it. This video will show you what to do in order to install TMS Web Core in Lazarus, and we will also build an example application that will show you what features are added to Lazarus after installation. What do we need to do in order to install TMS Web Core in Lazarus? First of all, let's talk about the Lazarus IDE that I use. I use Lazarus IDE version 2.0.2. This is one of the latest releases, mid-June 2019. It will work with this release just fine. As far as I know, TMS Web Core also works with version 1 of the Lazarus IDE, but be sure to upgrade, then you'll not run into any issues. Furthermore, I'll start after installation. So you already have installed your version of TMS Web Core on the disk, and you'll have a directory. I created it in Web Core, in the root directly. And apart from all these subdirectories, you'll also see TMS Web Core packages, not only for Red Studio, but also for Lazarus. So let's open the Lazarus package in Lazarus. We are already in my Web Core directory. There's plenty of LPK files. We will take TMS Web Core package lib lazarus.lpk, open it. We open it as a package. And then note that we don't have any TMS Web Core controls so far installed in the component palette. And we use install in the package. Yes, we also want to rebuild Lazarus. And after restart, we immediately see that the component palette has all the components from TMS Web. And we can further check if we go to Tools Options that we have an entry for the environment of TMS Web Core with all the directories in place. It might be that you have to make a change to the web compiler and to the Web Core directory at first. However, normally it's not necessary. Sometimes you have to make changes. You'll notice if you follow this Hello World approach and something doesn't work, the first thing you should do is check if all the directories are set up correctly. Let's build the first TMS Web Core project inside of the Lazarus IDE. We select Project, New Project, and here we have an entry for TMS Web Core application. Click OK. We can confirm this dialog with OK because we do want to create a form. This would give us the option not to create a form. So here we have our form, our web form, which is the representation of the website that we're building. We are going to build something more complex than a standard Hello World. Be sure that you use the TMS web controls and not the standard controls, because if you do that, you'll get an error message. You only can drop TWeb form components on a TWeb Core application, obviously. So be sure that you remain in these categories right here, TMS Web. So we're going to drop an edit field and a button, edit button. And this is a classic from TMS. We use a web list box. This is one of the very first projects that I built with TMS Web Core when it was released. And the button we implemented, we double click it and we say list web list box one items dot add. And what do you want to add? Web edit one dot. Do you see we have code completion in place and web edit one dot text equals nothing and web edit one set focus, so we can easily add multiple entries. We'll also change the caption of this to add, and the web edit, or the form, more likely the form, we set the event for on create to web edit one dot text is empty, and we also want to set focus. Of course, we can't do that in on create. We have to do that on show. Let's see where the on show event is. On show, insert it here. And let's run our first TMS Web Core application. And most likely, you'll get the same message that I get. It is not supported yet to run a Web Core application without saving it first. So what we need to do is we need to use project, save project S. And then we can save the project file, the HTML project file, the form, and that's it. And then we can run the application. Here we go. Bruno, Peter, Roman. See, it works just fine. Our application does exactly what we needed to do. We have a button, an edit, and our list box. Now on to something more complex. Let's use the Google Maps component, which is included in the standard set of components. We set it to AL client. We set the name to map. We also use geocoding, which is also available out of the box. Geocoding, we name it geo. And then we have several events to take care of. For example, as soon as the map is being shown, which is map loaded, we want to determine the position. So we say geo dot, and what's the method? Get geolocation. And as soon as we call that, as soon as the geolocation has been determined, we have the event on geolocation. Double click. What do we want to do as soon as we have our current position? We want to add that to the map. First of all, we want to center the map around our current location, and we also want to set a marker. So we can use the Google Map component to do that. So we use map dot, and then we have like set center is the method, and it requires two parameters. One is the latitude and the longitude. And guess what? Geolocation, the event, just provides these two parameters. Perfect. And then we can also add a marker very easily using the add marker. And what we're going to do is we're going to do just the same latitude, longitude, and we're going to provide a text which is saying, I am here, exclamation mark. And that's it. And this is already a very complex application to build in JavaScript. And we built it using Lazarus with the form visual form designer, dropping non-visual components, visual components, using as something as complex as the Google API. One thing is missing though. If you go to the Google Maps component, you see that you need an API key. I have a unit for that, which I will add, and that will provide my key. So my keys are in the unit uFlixKeys. So I'm going to add this unit to the users class, users uFlixKeys. And in the form create event, I basically assign the API key. API key equals tFlixKeys is the class name. And we have a method called getGoogleKey. That's it. We save everything and run the application. As soon as we run the application, we of course get error messages because I've totally forgot to remove the old demo test case code. So let's remove that. And here we have the application. It correctly determined the current position. The browser would normally ask if it is allowed to deliver the position. However, I already used it for project1.html on this local machine. So it's not going to ask again over and over again. And you see we have a fully working Google map, and I can hover over the pin and you see I am here. It's exactly what we specified in our application. So you see, developing TMS Web Core application with the Lazarus IDE is very simple. It has a visual designer. It has full code completion. There is no restriction whatsoever. However, there is a restriction on the available application types. Right now, as you can see very easily using project, new project, you only have a template for the TMS Web Core application, which means it's a web application. There are currently no wizards for Electron or PWA applications.